Your Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it's my honor and pleasure to welcome you here today to this important government summit that is our partner to DP World. The government summit has helped us to really improve our relation with many governments. DP World today has over 93 terminals. All our agreements and concessions are in partnership with government. So this platform is very important for us to meet government officials and improve our relation. We are committed to improve our relation with governments around the world to improve the infrastructure for transportation. Both government and business have and will continue to play a critical role in accelerating global economic recovery, one of the key themes of this summit. For this reason, I want to start by looking at the importance of trade globally, securing sustainable and equitable economic recovery. We need to collaborate together. The pandemic was a good lesson for us. It showed us how fragile the supply chain is. We need to rebuild it from the lesson we learned to make it more resilient and sustainable. In doing so, we can ensure economic benefit for our recovery that should be distributed fairly throughout the world. This can only be achieved by working together, all the stakeholders in the supply chain. It's taking a lot of effort to identify and develop the solution for this problem. And during the pandemic, the biggest problem for the world was how to develop medicines and vaccines for vaccinating the world. Now, it's been more than 2 years, we're still striving to distribute it. And unless everyone is vaccinated, this will not go away. But as we put the pandemic behind us and focus in shifting, reviving the economy, there is a way to achieve these two goals in tandem. One need not to be lifted in favor of the other. Businesses, each with their specialism and areas of expertise, have a vital role to play. As the world's leading end-to-end logistic company provider, DP World, we have a key role to play in ensuring our recovery and ongoing vaccine drive is supported by a resilient supply chain. To this end, we have partnered with UNICEF to distribute critical medical supplies through COVAX scheme over the last 15 months. Our global logistic network enabled UNICEF, whose executive director, Kathleen Russell, is here today with us, to reach countries and people that need it most. Together, we have the power to bring the positive change to the world. And the World Government Summit provides a vital platform for this. We have opportunities in this platform to discuss tools, policies, and models that will shape our future. Trade is a force for good. It helps countries to diversify their economies, create jobs, and enrich communities. But we have so much more to do to unlock the potential. Neither COVID pandemic or even the obstruction of Suez Canal can be treated as one-off events. They are vital lessons we learned to change. By collaborating together, we can deal with these issues. The ripple effect of just one issue when the canal was obstructed have pushed back delivery of cargo for months. We issued and initiated and developed many initiatives to communicate with our customers to resolve and address these issues. One of them is the World Logistic Passport, which is really a loyalty program. WLP, as we call it, is basically cargo that goes by air, comes from the Far East to Europe. So it goes this direction. And then it goes in a triangle back to Africa and Latin America. And what we're doing in WLP is we call it the South-South system, which means a straight line from the Far East, Dubai, Ethiopia, Ghana, and Latin America. This has saved a lot of money and time for the air cargo. Today, we are proud to say that we have signed 100 partners in the WLP. To sustain our recovery, we have to buy to provide the economies with the tools to continue. There are many examples where we have changed economies in countries, and I will give you an example of the Dominican Republic. When we started the operation there 15 years ago, it was a small market and only supplying itself. Today, we changed that from just an import country to a huge market. Today, 60% of business in Dominican comes through us. It is the first country in Latin America that has a free zone inside the port with logistics, warehouses, and it used to be a transshipment port, meaning that cargo come to them and change ship to go somewhere else. Today, the cargo goes straight to them into the free zone, and from there, it's been either add value and goes out. Free zones create the right condition, of course, for growth and give people the assurance and companies of that the laws do not change to allow them to progress. Also, another example for us is Rwanda. Africa is a continent with huge opportunities. The big problem with Africa is infrastructure. And we are big in Africa, and we have many ports there. 17 out of 54 countries in Africa are landlocked. In Africa, it doesn't matter how much the price of goods, what matters is it's available or not. So a classic example, which we are very proud of, is Rwanda. We started a dry port in Rwanda, which is basically like a logistic park on land. And we call it a dry port. It used to take 2 weeks to get the cargo from Dar es Salaam and Mombasa to Rwanda. Rwanda is important because from Rwanda you can supply Uganda, part of Tanzania, part of Kenya, Congo, Malawi, and Burundi, and Central African Republic. It takes 2 weeks, and the cost per container between $5,000 to $7,000. We started the operation. Today, it takes 1 day, and the cost came down from $7,000 to $2,800. We also acquired a big logistic company called Imperial Logistics in South Africa. This company is a 100-year-old company that actually supply cargo from the exporters to the consumer in Africa. They have 6,000 trucks, they deliver cargo, and they do something very interesting. We never did that before. They do something called contract manufacturing, meaning if they're exporting a huge commodity to somebody in a destination, they might decide to speed it up, maybe they should manufacture it. So they go to the supplier and tell him, instead of shipping, let's manufacture it here. And they do that. So we do have that with Imperial, which will help us in all our ports. The other thing we learned from the pandemic is that we have to use technology. And so we started to accelerate the creation of digital platforms. which allow us to communicate with our people. Now, DP World is a company that handles a lot of cargo. So we have 93 terminals around the world. These terminals handle about 75 million containers. In value, the customers move almost $3.5 trillion of cargo through our terminals. That means $400,000 of cargo every hour, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. That is a lot of information. So in our platforms and in our business, we analyze this. So today, we convert this information, which is vast, into data, and data into good decisions. So we could go to our customer and tell them, you are handling this much, but maybe there are other ways that you can do it that will save you money. That's how we get involved in the end-to-end solutions. We recently also launched Cargos. It's a platform for people who ship to book cargo on this. So if you think of booking.com for holidays and hotel, Cargos is like the booking.com of cargo. People book and they get the best rate. We also have Freight Alliance, which is a platform where the freight forwarders fight together to give the best rate. And then we also launched Dubai.com. It is spelled D-U-B-U-Y. And that is a B2B marketplace. So what do? We basically digitalize the products for the traders. One of the biggest competition for the traders anywhere in the world is that people buy through Amazon or through Alibaba. But with Dubai.com, it allows the trader to sell directly. So in Tanzania, for example, we launched Dubai.com, and we are digitalizing their economy. So a trader is looking to buy something. He can go on this website and find a seller from any economies that we have digital their trade. So we're doing the digitalization in Dubai, in a digital cargo. We're doing it in Tanzania. We're doing it in other countries. This will allow people to collaborate and have information for them to buy the products much faster. In conclusion, I'd like to thank the organizers for the summit, for bringing us all together under one roof. We have fantastic opportunities here to spark ideas that will shape the next stage of a fairer and more effective long-term recovery. Sustained collaboration like this is essential. We are to successfully tackle the challenges we are facing. I look forward to continue to meet with many of you today and tomorrow as we move forward together. Thank you very much.